in the raw.
Dearest beloved divine friends and families, brothers and sisters in Guyana and around the world, I know I was mystic for quite a while, and I know that many people have been missing me and asking. Well, I was not in my very best of health, and consequently, I had to travel to doctors and then even a bit overseas. But nothing serious. By grace of God, it was just a nerve causing a tremendous headache. And by the God's grace, I'm fine. Now, I would like you to share this. Whenever you see RK's Guyana Free Media, you must share to your friends and families around the world, because it will be very topical. The politics and the criminality are very hot in Guyana. And certain political elements are responsible for the fires that's taking place in Guyana. I recall one time when there was a fire some years ago in the previous PPP government. There was a burning of the Ministry of Labor on Homestretch Avenue. And we know a man who was very hot about this. And that man used to be there. Now he's living in a basement in New York City. Rickford Burke, who is threatening to destroy a major segment of the Guyanese population and destroy their businesses, and wanting people to be beaten, raped and murdered, as happened in Region 5 just after the elections when the PPPC had won the elections. So be careful with those people, friends and family, brothers and sisters, all Guyanese. Do not allow yourself to destroy, break and mash up our country. So today, what do I want to talk about? Here I'm going to give you some information about Winston Jordan. Then I'm going to make a comment. Breaking news, Winston Jordan, former finance minister, to face criminal charges over sale of GRE vehicles to his son and other relatives and other corrupt transactions. Former finance minister under the APNU and AFC, Winston Jordan is among several former government officials that will soon face the courts on charges stemming from several corrupt acts carried out during the tenure of the coalition administration, the thing called APNU and AFC. Well, the AFC has gone into garbage, my own words. And the APNU is in trouble, breaking apart, internal warfare. Ladies and gentlemen, Attorney General Anil Nandalal today revealed that Jordan will soon be prosecuted over his involvement in the sale of several high-end vehicles from the Guyana Revenue Authority without due process to his relatives, to his son. He also is expected to face charges over his role in the sale of several state properties, many far below market value and without the requisite public procurement process. These sales, Nandalal said, took place after the coalition government fell on a no-confidence vote in December 2018, and even after its loss at the March 2nd, 2020 elections. And the commentary here was, let him and others go home, from yours truly. And Joseph Harmon, who was in China, as it is alleged, etc. And Trotman, who signed out Guyana Oil and never read the contract and claimed that former President Granger knew about it, and all in the government. Let him pay the billions we lost. Friends and families, remember, it was Harmon who tried to destroy my business. And consequently, my friends and families, about 10,000 in the country, will never vote, even though they might be of a particular ethnicity on their side. Or the mixed ethnicity general in Guyana are my friends and families, but none of them voted for them. So they want to know how they lost the election. It was because of their deceit and their dishonesty. And Mr. Harmon trying to destroy my business and my life, and then doing nothing for the poor people, only for his big shot friends, especially the biggest contractor ones, selling out the lands and the properties and everything that belonged to Guy, and even saving one of them from being prosecuted after he never paid any major income tax or taxes on the importation of a most expensive vehicle in the country. Friends and families, let us not forget ever that it was this man who said he thought that the money was a gift. So he thought it was his money, the $18 million from ExxonMobil. Imagine, a man who's a finance minister thought the money was a gift. Well, he has to go to court. He has to face the music. He has to answer That is the way. We are a country with due process, legal possibilities, ladies and gentlemen, and also doing so much of skullduggeries and deceit. Imagine what they did. They gave one of their big boys in a big position and big salary millions of dollars to open a barber shop with your tax dollars and mine. So friends and family, brothers and sisters around the world, in the raw, me, your friend, your brother, Haji Dr. Roshan Khan, is asking that you spread this worldwide. It is now national and international news. On behalf of RKS Guyana Free Media, in the raw, your friend, your brother, saying farewell, dearest, beloved, divine brothers and sisters. In the raw, RKS Guyana Free Media. A presentation by your friend, your brother, me, Haji Dr. Roshan Khan, for a better Guyana, for democracy, for peace, goodwill to prevail in the land, and thieves and skullduggers must face the music to go home to prison. And be assured of one thing, that unlike the fake charges that they had included against some former government ministers of the PPPC, which all was thrown out by the courts, trust me, with one like Mahavir Anil Nandalal, the case against anyone who is, and those alleged to have been in criminality, and in this case, Mr. Jordan, must face the music in the raw.